No diet is cruelty-free. So why do vegans insist they are morally superior? We know the vegan diet has been disproven from a nutrition as well as environmental standpoint. But who dictates life? We know plants interact with each other and try to survive, defending themselves from predators. But their lives are less valuable? There was a study late last year that showed plants releasing a similar nervous system-like signal throughout their body, similar to the pain response in humans and other animals. And on that topic, fish might not actually feel pain themselves. They don't possess a neocortex, which is the first sign, and they don't contain certain nerve fibers that are found in mammals. They show minor or no reactions to extremely painful interventions. And painkillers like morphine in fish seemed relatively ineffective. We also know that invertebrates, particularly mollusks like oysters, mussels, clams, are non-sentient. So what's the argument here, that you should only consume non-sentient beings? No, that's not it. Being vegan means you don't consume animal products. And this is where it becomes very clear that veganism is a philosophy and a belief, not a diet. So it should have no association with nutrition. Now, if the vegan philosophy falls in line with not harming animals, why are these vegans trying to feed their pets that are carnivorous a vegan diet? The mental gymnastics that these vegans go through to justify their beliefs is pretty shocking, to say the least. Let's touch on some more serious concerns. Increase the chance your child abuses substances, likely due to lack of nutrients during development. Starving your baby with a vegan concoction because it's more in line with your lifestyle?
And I was craving, like, for example, like dumplings pelmeni, and usually they were made with meat, but when I was a kid, I used to eat as well mushroom pelmeni, and they were delicious and I loved them. And that was what I was craving. I was craving mushroom ones, not the meat ones, because that for me, like, doesn't connect into my head as food anymore. So I can't even, like, imagine how it is that you are pregnant and you, like, start craving something and you just eat and it seems normal to you and seems fine. I don't know, like, I can't understand myself personally. And that's what I was craving. I was craving a vegan version of that same food.
Denying animal food cravings and starving your baby? More starvation? What a surprise. Having your child taken away because of serious injuries related to nutrient deficiencies? If the vegan diet wasn't a religion, it would have been shut down already. It's completely crazy, despite all this wacko stuff happening related directly to the vegan diet, that there aren't regulations around it. What we've seen so far is that vegans seem to be okay with harming humans, and there isn't too much logic around what dictates what they should be eating outside of a purely philosophical belief. What they enjoy sweeping under the rug, though, is how many animals are killed when farming plants. It takes life to give life. Imagine prepping a field for any sort of crop. First, you have to spray herbicides, pesticides, killing trillions of things on the bottom of the food chain and at the top of the food chain. You kill the food source for the lizards, you kill the food source for the rats, the mice, then you kill the food source for the hawks or the birds because they eat the mice. There is massive animal death in just spraying the herbicides and pesticides. Then you till the soil, you completely ravage the biodiversity in the soil and kill everything. Now, just about everything has died, whether directly from the herbicides and pesticides, because it's been displaced and it's starved to death, or because a predator killed it after it lost its shelter. So now you're planting all these crops and they're growing quickly and there's a new food source. So the animals that did survive replicate incredibly quickly. But you have to harvest that food, don't you? When you run those combines through the field, you kill some animals. Most of the animals are not killed in the actual harvesting process. What happens is you harvest that wheat, the animals lose their food source and their shelter, they're picked off by predators and they starve to death. And then the whole cycle continues. Ladies and gentlemen, vegans kill just as many sentient beings as a carnivore does, if not more. And the most vegan diet there is would be consuming one grass-fed animal per year, one or two cows per year. Because what justifies killing trillions of bugs, rodents, all of these things, ruining the biodiversity of the soil, destroying the environment? Because what? It doesn't have eyes and a face? Vegans are basically picking and choosing what they deem as sentience without proof and basing their entire lifestyle off of it. And if someone wants to argue that these grains and crops are being fed to animals, yeah, some of them are, about 40%. But that other 60% is going to give you SIBO and Crohn's disease on your vegan diet. And I hate to break it to you, ladies and gentlemen, cows can eat grass. And if we want to argue that there isn't enough land to do that, it's a ridiculous straw man argument. When the human race goes infertile because of the vegan diet in 50 years, there will be plenty of land for cattle. In regards to some plant-based foods that vegans are eating, it's also not so good. Cashews are one of the most labor-intensive foods to produce. And since they are actually toxic, the people peeling them receive caustic burns from the acids between the two layers of the nut. Some of these are produced in forced labor camps. Chocolate and coffee are two other crops that have been produced by child laborers and farm workers in dangerous conditions, being exposed to toxic chemicals, living in incredibly poor conditions, pretty much being slaves. Although these foods aren't exclusive to vegans, it's important to keep in mind that most people ignore the steps of food production and what is required to grow, harvest, and ship the food. These vegans think they're better than omnivores, yet they're still buying the tomatoes that were picked by slaves. But hey, don't stop eating cashews, because if you do, the workers will suffer. They'll be paid less, have to work more hours, and kept in harsher conditions. Problems get created without solutions. In Malaysia, there have been farm workers who were brainwashed with religion and trapped in debt to be kept on the farm. Sounds awfully familiar. Kinda like vegans being brainwashed by the face value of the movement and then being kept in because of their newly found moral and ethical obligations. Migrant workers who speak no English are sold to a crew boss and obligated to pick fruit to work off the price of their purchase. They are kept in horrible conditions, charged for rent, meals, given alcohol credit to become addicted. But hey, tomatoes don't have eyes and a face, so you can eat them. Palm oil is something used in a lot of refined foods, especially vegan products. Not only is it a highly inflammatory omega-6 fat, animals on palm oil plantations are shot and beaten when they're seen eating palm fruit. Even for coconuts, they train monkeys that are able to pick 300 to 1,000 coconuts per day. They're chained by the neck and trained to pick ripe coconuts, then forced to do so. And forced labor isn't just an issue in plant harvesting. Almost all agriculture contains these problems to some degree. What about avocados and almonds requiring bees to fertilize crops? Migratory beekeeping is certainly something vegans would be against. But hey, Tyson launched some vegan protein. Why don't you go have some of that? It doesn't matter that they did a little shh on a few billion chickens before launching their plant-based, cruelty-free product. I say this in almost every single video, but it's interesting. How can someone be wrong on literally every single thing by taking information at face value? Unfortunately, there are very few people on the planet willing to admit they are wrong, own up to their mistakes, and move back to something reasonable. Or it could be simple monetary interest. I thought it was comical how on the plant-based news channel, they talk about how good vegan is for the environment, for your health, from a moral and ethical standpoint. And then at the end of that video, they're selling you some dirt packed into a plastic tub so you can continue your plant-based regimen. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. Please like, subscribe, hit the bell icon, and share the video if you enjoyed it. Down below in the comments, you'll find things ranging from my Amazon shop, where I have a bunch of products I use in my day-to-day life. You can check out my Patreon. That is a great way to support me, as well as get one-on-one personalized question support. I'm on Instagram, guys. I'm on Twitter. If you want to join the carnivore community, we have carnivoreform.com. I also just started my own podcast, Perfected Health. It's about optimizing every aspect of our lifestyle. We had Ivor Cummins on last week. If you guys do want to reach out to me for one-on-one consultations, you can send me an email, frankatofano@gmail.com, or contact me through the form on my website below, frank-tofano.com. You guys enjoy the rest of your week.